Hey guys, this is Marie, and I'm back with another video, and this video is going to be Hermit Crab Update. So let's get started. So in this video, I will be showing you and talking to you a little bit about each Hermit Crab and how they're doing. Also, I'm going to give you a little update about me losing a couple of Hermit Crabs. So here we go. If you guys are new to my channel, welcome to the Dolphin Kitty World family. This is my 20-gallon long Hermit Crab tank, and I have a total of 8 Hermit Crabs. I have 4 Ecuadorian and 4 Purple Pincher Hermit Crabs. So let's go ahead and tell you about the Hermit Crabs. Now I'm going to go ahead and update you about the Hermit Crabs that have passed away recently. Now one of my Hermit Crabs was in a painted shell, and most of you guys probably know him. He was named Mickey, and Mickey came from Petco, and he was also, like I said, in a painted shell. I had him for not even a year yet, and he was doing pretty good. He seemed like he was very happy and healthy. He had done 3 molts with me, and I was very excited and very happy for him because, you know, for him being in a painted shell, that's pretty much very hard for them to do a good molt, and he did absolutely wonderful in all 3 of them, and I'm very happy that he did that at that time. Like I said, he was in a painted shell for a very long time since I had him. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys. This is the painted shell that he was in. It's just blue, pink, and like a green color. And you guys can see that some of the paint has already been chipped off when he was in this shell. Now recently, probably last month, I believe, I did an Instagram video that Mickey actually finally changed his shell and went into a different shell. And he stayed in that shell for probably like a day, and then he moved out of that shell and went to another shell. And then he did it again probably the day after he moved out of that shell and went to another shell. And each shell that he went into was like smaller and smaller. It did not fit him very well. Now, the 4th time, I think when I woke up that morning, I always turn on the Hermit Crab tank light and go ahead and check on all the Hermit Crabs just to make sure they're doing pretty well and who is up and who is down. And I noticed as soon as I turned on the light, Mickey was completely out of his shell. He was not in his shell at all. He was just laying there completely naked and just hanging out. I'm not sure what he was doing and why he was out of his shell, but he was just completely naked and was not in a shell at all. I took 3 shells that he kind of had moved into recently and put those shells next to him to see if he would go back into the shell. And then I left him alone for a while, went to work, and then came home that afternoon, and he ended up passing away. He did not go into the shell. He just was completely just laid there and was completely gone. So he never moved back into a shell. I'm not sure what was going on with him. The only thing I can think of was because of me taking out his painted shell, he was probably very stressed and upset because he could not go back into that shell and he couldn't find it. And he didn't like any of the other shells that he was trying to go into. And he just maybe just gave up and then just end up passing away. None of the hermit crabs seemed to bother him when he was out of his shell. I didn't see nothing like tore like legs or anything like that, or like they were trying to eat him. So they didn't bother him, but it was very upsetting because, you know, I had him for not a very long time, but long enough to point where he was molting. He molted with me 3 times, and I was just so proud of him, and I just wanted him to get out of that shell so he can get into a nice beautiful shell, because he was actually one of the first hermit crabs that I actually held in my hand for the very first time. So, and he was a very sweet hermit crab. But unfortunately, yes, he did pass away. So I'm very upset about that. But hopefully he had a good little bit of life when he was with me. And like I said, he did 3 molts and he was doing very well and very happy and healthy. But I guess unfortunately him being out of that painted shell, this upset him and stressed him out to the point where he just gave up and passed away. Now, I just cleaned my hermit crab tonight before making this video, and I was checking on all the hermit crabs, and all of them were doing pretty well. And I noticed that when I was digging, there was an empty shell that you can see this hermit crab right here. This is Neptune. And that shell that he had on, that hermit crab shell was completely empty. And that was one of my newest hermit crabs I have just gotten, probably about a month ago. And her name was Jade, and she was an Ecuadorian hermit crab. Now, Jade and Neptune right here, I got them two at the same time, and they were both in the shell. And for some reason, Neptune stays up, but Jade went down under the substrate, and she was down there for a good 2 months. So I figured she was molting, so I left her alone. And tonight, I decided to go ahead and clean out the hermit crab tank before I did a video for you guys. And I found her empty shell. And I had digged all over the place and could not find her. So I have no idea what happened to her. I don't know if the hermit crabs ate her or if she just... I don't know. I'm very confused because that really never happened to me. I never had a hermit crab disappear like that. I mean, I looked through all the substrate, every inch of the substrate, and I cannot find her. So I don't know if she just came out of the shell and never found her way back, and then one of the hermit crabs down there ate her, or what happened. But I didn't find any of her body or her or anything, so I don't know what's going on with her. But unfortunately, apparently she passed away also. So now it's Mickey and Jade that's been passed away. And I'm not sure how long she's been gone because, like I said, she's been down there for 2 months. So I thought she was molting, and so I left her alone. So, I mean, she could have been down there for a while and I would have never known. But, yep, so she has gone, and so has Mickey. Now, I didn't show you guys a video of the recent two new ones I have gotten, probably the last month or the month before. And one of them is right here. And this one is a female, and yes, she is in a painted shell, so hopefully she'll change. She is an Ecuadorian hermit crab, and she's doing very well, and her name is Minnie. So since I had a Mickey, I wanted to do a Minnie. So there she is. She's in a greenish, a blue, yellow, and blue and yellow hermit crab shell. And she's an Ecuadorian, and she's been doing wonderful. She's very shy. She doesn't hang out very often. She usually goes down into the substrate, but she's doing pretty good. And if you guys probably can't see because of the light, let me open the lid a little bit. But right there on the other side is Pat. There's Minnie. I think this is the closest I ever gotten to her. She's so cute and adorable. She's probably like a medium-sized hermit crab. I think she's almost the same size as Mickey. Mickey might have been just a little bit bigger than her. And then Patches over there. Now, a funny story while I'm showing you guys Patch. Recently, right after I have gotten Jade and Neptune, probably the day after I got them two, I had turned on my hermit crab tank, and I noticed that Neptune and Patch had changed shells. Now, Neptune was in that shell like Patch was in. And then Patch was in actually this shell right here. I'll show you. Patch was in this shell since I have gotten her. So apparently them two had like swapped shells overnight because Neptune was in this one and then Patch was in his shell for the longest time. So I thought that was pretty strange and weird because I'd never had hermit crabs actually do that. But I mean, they had no problems or anything. There was no issues or anything like that. So other than that, the only other thing is the other hermit crab that I have gotten the same time as Minnie was named Coconut. And Coconut was and also in a painted shell. Let me see if I can find him in here. They're all scattered around. He was in here earlier. He's over here. Give me 1 second, guys. There he is. Okay, let me grab him and show you guys real fast. Alright, so right here is Coconut. And as you guys can see here, he's in a natural shell. And he was actually in a painted shell. And this painted shell was horrible. I couldn't believe it. And the reason why I picked Coconut was because I wanted him to get out of that shell. Because it was so terrible. It was ridiculous. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what the shell looked like. So here is the shell. It's so thick and heavy. It looks like a baseball cap, I guess you want to say. And this shell is so heavy, when he would try to walk, he would barely even be out of his shell. I mean, he would just walk, and you couldn't even see him. He was covered completely into this shell because it was so small and tiny and heavy. He couldn't walk as good as he's supposed to walk. But this shell was terrible. And probably like a day after that, he actually moved out of that, out of this shell and went into that shell. So I was very happy for him. I was very excited and glad that he had moved out. So other than that, all the hermit crabs are doing wonderful. Everybody is up because, like I said, I had just cleaned the hermit crab tank. And I wanted to let you guys see all the new hermit crabs and all the other hermit crabs. There's a purple pincher hermit crab right there. And then actually right there in the corner is Coconut and I'm not sure. Oh, and Patch. So Patch and Coconut is over there. And then here is Molly. Molly is doing wonderful. And then there's another purple pincher back there. I can't tell who that is. I think that's Summer. And I'm not sure where all the other ones are. I think there was another one over here earlier. Yep. There's another purple pincher. And this one is Sky. Sky is the one that I'm not sure if it was a male or a female, so I just named her him Sky. I figured that would be a perfect name for a boy or a girl because she's very cute and adorable, but just never knew if she was a male or a female. And still to this day, I still don't know if she's a male or female. And there's Molly climbing up their branch. And then Neptune is over here climbing around. Oh, that's Patch. Sorry. But other than that, all the hermit crabs are absolutely doing wonderful. All of them are very happy and healthy in this crab habitat, and they're doing pretty well. So that is my hermit crab tank update. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give this video a big thumbs up, comment down below, and definitely don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more. Until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!